now is a really exciting time to rediscover the wisdom that's deposited over thousands of years for the whole entire world using plants as herbal remedy. In the old days, it's very hard to study a plant which has no genetic tools. Nowadays, we can easily sequence the whole entire genome and all the genes expressed in any tissue from these medicinal plants. And from that sequence, the data sets easily identify the genes encoding those enzymes that are responsible for manufacturing these interesting molecules that can eventually make into medicine.
Previous models suggested that there were these lock and key interactions between proteins, but there's something on top of that that's allowing for this big reservoir of material to be collected and concentrated at specific locations.
So they're forming these round spherical droplets that settle on the glass and they can fuse together to form these condensates. It's amazing.
We can target them and destroy these liquid droplets where they are not supposed to be.
Those treatments are not going to be found by looking in the old places. So looking somewhere new that I think is really promising is probably the most exciting part.
It was first found by Sidney Farber here in Boston more than 60 years ago. We can use a CRISPR screen and ask, instead of focusing on what is known about methotrexate, we can ask what is unknown about methotrexate. If we can improve therapy through any modification of something as simple as an amino acid, we have it in our egg, we have it in our chicken that we eat, right? Things that are as simple as that are always promising to us.